Ill-advised and a rash recommendation. The reactions this evening to the proposal by the chairman of the Economic Growth Council, Michael Ichin, for non-performing permanent secretaries to be sacked. Here's TVJ's Vashon Brown with this primetime news follow-up.
The chairman of the Economic Growth Council, Michael Ichin, on Wednesday called for changes to the laws so that non-performing permanent secretaries can be removed from their posts. Executive Director of the Jamaica Accountability Meter Portal, Jeanette Calder, says she's heard the comments.
I think that it, off the top of my head, was a little bit of a rash recommendation. I think the problem goes far deeper than just accountability as it relates to the permanent secretary.
For attorney at law and businessman Howard Mitchell, the comments were ill-advised.
Perhaps he needs to take counsel because, first of all, permanent secretaries can be fired. Under Section 125 of the Constitution of Jamaica, there is established a public services commission is established, and that commission has the responsibility to deal with the employment, the emoluments, and the termination of permanent secretaries. So that question is therefore, that then becomes a question of whether or not that process is a difficult process.
He argues that though he understands Mr. Leachin's frustration, to single out permanent secretaries is unfair. Mr. Mitchell says the real problem is public sector reform, which has not been dealt with for over 25 years. The permanent secretary's role rests in the fact that he or she is the chief policy advisor to the relevant portfolio minister, a role defined in the Constitution. Permanent secretaries sign what's called a letter of appointment when they get the job. Among other things, the letter states that, quote, you have a particular responsibility in seeing that appropriate advice is tendered to your minister or board on all matters of financial propriety and regularity, and more broadly as to all considerations of prudent and economical administration, end quote.
Yeah, I was a little surprised to see that the permanent secretary is required to comply with what a minister asks of he or she. However, what the letter of appointment says is, though you must comply, then you have an obligation to do what? To inform the financial secretary, the auditor general, the Ministry of Finance, what it is you have recommended versus what the minister is asking you to do.
With that in mind, Ms. Calder argues that discussions about accountability should also include the minister.
This current administration promised a very important thing, which is job descriptions for ministers. Now, if we are talking about accountability, it is nigh impossible for citizens. We are the checks and balance, you know, of a democracy. How do we hold a minister or any public official to account if I don't know what your job is? And that is part of the challenge that Mr. Chin has not confronted and has not dealt with.
Vashon Brown, TVJ News.